Good afternoon, students. All of you, welcome back to live online webinar class. Okay, we are going to discuss about our IPE part like revision. Okay, don't be take very neglect, because this each and every class used for your future steps. Okay, students, after completion of our second chapter, next we are going to discuss about the our third chapter, the nothing but the animal diversity one. Okay, we already know about this all topics, and again we discuss about this. Okay, first of all we are going to discuss about the 2 marks questions. Okay, the first question: what are the functions of canal system of sponges? Okay, what is the question? What are the functions of canal system of sponges? The answer is the functions of canal system. First of all, what is the canal system, student? Here, this is the one sponge. Okay. Here we observe the pores on their body. These pores are forms the canal like structure, canal like structures. Okay, this canal system works for the gathering of the food, because these sponges all are aquatic forms. Okay, they are in a water, so the what in the water the sponges are absorb the food by the using of canal system, and also help for the respiration. Okay, which purpose? The exchange of gases, and next the excretion also, means the waste matter which is produced in the sponges are also derived from the canal system. Okay, those are the most important functions of the canal system, which is the important metabolic system present in the sponges. Okay, students. Then next, what are two chief morphological body forms of cnidarians? What are their chief functions? Okay, what is the question? What are the two chief morphological body forms of cnidarians, and what are their chief functions? Okay, the two chief morphological body forms of cnidarians are polyform and medusa form. Here, students, here we already know about the cnidarian body. Here two types of the body forms we observe. What are their polypoid forms and medusa forms? Okay, polypoid forms and medusa form. Here function of the polyp means it is a nutritive zooid. What is that? Nutritive zooid, and reproduce medusa asexually, means here polyp produce medusa by the asexual manner. Okay, and what is the function of medusa? It is a reproductive zooid. Reproductive zooid. Okay, medusa reproduce polyps by sexually. Here that is the difference between polyform and medusa form of the cnidarians also. What is that? First one, polyp is a nutritive zooid. It reproduces medusa by the asexually. Here this point is important. And next to medusa produce polyp by the sexual manner. Okay, that is the important one. Next, third question: what is metagenesis? Animals belongs to which phylum exhibit metagenesis? Okay, students, what is that? What is metagenesis? Here metagenesis means sexual and asexual forms alternative with each other is called metagenesis. Okay, here two types of the alternate forms are produced from a organism. That type of procedure is called metagenesis. Okay, or alteration of the generations also. Alteration of generations means polypoid form produce medusa asexually, medusa produce polypoid in a sexual manner. So both are different, but they are in a parallel position. Means here the medusa produce polypoid forms produce medusa by the asexual, And Medusa produce polypid from sexual manner. Animals belongs cnidarian phylum. Which phylum? Cnidarian. Okay. After the sponges means porifera, we already discussed about the cnidarian phylum. Okay. So here animals belongs to the cnidaria phylum exhibit metagenesis. Okay, students. The next two question, fourth question, what is that? What are the excretory cells of flatworms called? What is the other important function of these specialized cells? Okay, what are the excretory cells of flatworms? Okay, after the cnidarians, which phylum we will observe? What is that, students? Platyhelminthes. So flatworms are belongs to the Platyhelminthes. So here excretory organs of the flatworms are called which one? Phloem cells. What is that? Phloem cells are protonephridia. Proto means what? The primitive one. Okay. Here phloem cells are produce the means excretory material in the flatworms. And osmoregulation is the other important function of these cells. Osmoregulation means what, students? Here osmoregulation means, what is that? The maintenance. What is that? Maintenance of the body in the equilibrium manner. Means here maintenance of the body fluids in the equal. Inner body fluids in the equal. So that type of process is called osmoregulation. These cells like phloem cells are produced. Which type? Osmoregulatory function also. Okay. Then next, another question. Distinguish between the amphids and plasmids. So this is a very, very important question and important for our competitive also. Okay, so here amphids means they are cuticular depression around oral region performing chemoreceptor function. Okay, here chemoreceptor, the word is very important. Here, where amphids are present means amphids are the cuticular. Cuticular means what? This is a layer which is present in the primitive organism. Okay, cuticular layer. So here the round oral region means, for example, it is a one of the organism. Here oral position is present at the anterior region. So here oral region performing chemoreceptor means chemicals are acts on the sensory function. What is that? Sensory function. So that's why here they are cuticular depression around oral region performing chemoreceptor function. Okay, then plasmids. They are posterior glandulosensory structure. Posterior region means what, students? Here, end of the body. This is the posterior one and this is the anterior one. They are posterior glandulosensory structures. Okay, and then they are present in class vast media and vast media. Okay, this is the class which is belonging to the roundworms. Okay, here vast media and vast media. But here the plasmids are present only in the class vast media. Okay. Okay, students. The next, another question. What is the essential difference between a flatworm and a roundworm with reference to the periviscidal area of their bodies? Okay, students, this is also used for your competitive question. What is that? Flatworm, differences between the flatworm and roundworm. Means generally the difference between Platyhelminthes and Nematyhelminthes. Okay, here flatworms are acoelomates. What is that, students? Flatworms are the acoelomates. Means here coelo means absent. Coelo means what, students? Coelom is a body cavity which builds the our vital organs. Okay. Here flatworms are acoelomates. Perivisceral cavity is absent. Here perivisceral cavity is absent. Body cavity means what? Cavity means a hollow space. Here perivisceral cavity is absent and coelom also absent. So that's why they are the acoelomates. But in the roundworm case, the roundworms are pseudocoelomates. Pseudo means what? False. What is that, students? False. False coelom. Here, perivisceral cavity is present, but it is not a true coelom. That's why we are called pseudocoelomates. Okay, students. Next, second point, the perivisceral area of flatworm is filled with mesenchymal tissue. For example, it is a one organism's blastocyst in the flatworm. Okay, so here the mesenchyme, the worms are, this perivisceral cavity is filled with the mesenchymal tissue. But in the case of the roundworm, the perivisceral area of flatworms is filled with the pseudocoelom fluid here. Okay, pseudocoelom. But here mesenchyme tissue is present, but against the flatworms here, what will we observe? Pseudocoelom fluid is present. Okay, students. Then next, another question. Okay, students. Here. What do you call the locomotor structures of Neris? Why is Neris is called a polychaete? Here, the locomotion means what? The movement means they are moved from one place to another place. We are using our legs for our locomotion. As this purpose, here the Neris. Neris is belong to the which phylum? Which phylum, students? All of you recall? The Neris means the polychaeta. The class polychaeta. Okay. Where it present? In the annelida. The locomotor structure of Neris are which one? Parapodia. Okay, students. For example, it is a Neris. We also call as a sandworm. Here we observe the most of the parapodia present in their lateral. Okay, lateral side, we observe the parapodia. And many setae also present on this parapodia. Many setae also present for the locomotion. Okay, students, is called a polychaeta. Why we are called as the Neris in the class of polychaeta? Means the locomotor structure of the Neris are parapodia. Many setae are present in Neris. So it is called polychaete. Okay, that is the reason. And then students, what is the botryoidal tissue? Another question, what is that? What is botryoidal tissue? The coelom of hirudinians. Okay, hirudinians means what? The leeches. What is that? Leeches. Okay, the body cavity coelom is present. So coelom of hirudinians is filled with a tissue called, what is that? Botryoidal tissue. Okay. It's look like a bunch of grapes. What is that? Bunch of grapes. It looks like the bunch of grapes. Okay. Next, what is the function of the botryoidal tissue? Means it performs the excretory storage of iron and calcium. Okay. What is the function of the botryoidal tissue? All of you listen. It is very important. It performs the excretion and the storage of excess iron and calcium, and also revascularization in areas of injury. For example, if any injury is appears, what will happen? This botryoidal tissue fill this injury, and what will happen? Revascularization is happen. Okay, all of you understand? Next, another question. What are the respiratory structures of limulus and palamanus respectively? Okay, respiratory structures of the limulus and palamanus. What is that? Book gills are the respiratory structure of the, which one, students? All of you recall, this is also very important question. Limulus and another one, palamanus is have a respiratory structure, book lungs. What is that? Book lungs. Okay, and then next, which arthropod you have studied is called a living fossil? Name its respiratory organ. Which arthropod you have studied a living fossil? Here, student. What is the living fossil? Limulus. Okay, which organ? Limulus. Which organism? Okay, next, what are the respiratory organs? Means book gills. What is the students? Book gills are the respiratory organs of limulus. here living fossil means students here if any organism going to extinct and so many after years ago it's next it will be shown in any area the type of organisms are called what is that living fossils limulus is the living fossil and respiratory organism what bugles what is that students bugles and how do you identify a chiton from a external appearance how many pairs of gills help in the respiration of chiton okay here chiton is belongs to the phylum mollusca the shell bearing organism here chiton is it can be identified by its shell how can we identify by its shell it is dorsal dorsal means which one students this is the dorsal position of an organism and ventral position is in their lower side okay and consists of 8 transverse plates what is that 8 transverse plates 1 2 3 4 5 6 like that 8 transverse plates are observed in the chiton and what are the respiratory organs means gills are the respiratory organs and how many pairs of the gills is present means 6 to 88 pairs of gills help in the respiration okay students next another question what is the function of radula give the name of group of molluscs which do not possess a of radula this is also very important student it is one of the to bit also what the mastigatory rupturing okay organ present in the buccal cavity of mollusca where it locates the buccal cavity region in the oral surface of the molluscans in pelecypoda or bivalvia it is absent this is a very important student is which radula also one of the chief character of the mollusca we already know okay but in the pelecypoda or bivalvia class it does not observe any radula in their structure okay okay students the next another question what is Aristotle length give one example of an animal possessing it okay what is the Aristotle length here students all of you look into this picture here we observe the mouth of the echinoids for example it is the mouth of the echinoids we observe the five jaw like structure present in the oral surface of the echinoids okay a complex five jawed masticatory apparatus in the mouth of echinoids is called Aristotle lantern here Aristotle may introduce this Aristotle lantern in the echinoids that's why the name will come Aristotle's lantern example echinus what is that echinus the next what are the blood glands in peritima blood glands in the circulatory system we discuss about the in peritima blood glands are present in fourth fifth and sixth segment they produce blood cells and hemoglobin here blood glands of peritima is present in the which segments for example it is a peritima it is the fourth segment fifth segment sixth one here we observe the blood glands of peritima and it produce the blood cells like rbc wbc like that and also hemoglobin okay students here in the earthworm condition hemoglobin is dissolved in the plasma okay that is also very important bit okay the next these are the 2 marks questions very important and also used for the competitive exam and then next we enter into the short answers questions which is important for the 4 marks okay here write short notes on the silent features of anthozoans what is the students anthozoans here anthozoans are commonly called as what is that sea anemones here advaisha is there So it is a one of the sea anemone. They are sedentary means what? They did not move from one place to another place. They are the sedentary and only polypoid in form. Means here in the cnidarian case, we observe the two types of the body forms. What are that? Polypoid and medusa forms. Here, if they are the sedentary and only polypoid in form, means medusa is absent. And cylindron is divided into several compartments. Cylindron means what? The coelom. Okay. The hollow space. It is separated by the several compartments like this. Okay, students. Next, by vertical septa and called mesenteries. These are called mesenteries. Okay, then next. Mesoglia contains connective tissue. Mesoglia lo em untai? Connective tissue. And then nidocytes occur both in the ectoderm and endoderm. This is the nidocytes are the cells which are used for defense mechanism in the cnidarians. We already know. So these nidocytes occur both in the ectoderm and endoderm. Okay. Then next, germ cells are derived from endoderm. But germ cells are derived from which portion, students? Endoderm. Here, three types of germinal layers. We already know about this. Ectoderm and middle mesoderm and inner endoderm. Here, ectoderm and endoderm possess a nidocyte cells. The germ cells are derived from which portion? Endoderm. And for examples are the adnexia and gorgonia. Okay. See fan. The general name. Okay. Next. These are the general characters of the anthozoans. What is the example, students? Adnexates look like a flower bucket. Okay. Next. What are the silent features exhibit by polychaetes? What is that? Silent features exhibit by polychaetes. Polychaetes means what? In the 2 marks question, we already discussed. What is that? The nereces belong to the polychaeta. So here poly means what? Many. But students, many. Cete means cete. Includes marine annelids commonly called bristle worms. Okay, they are include marine annelids. Means marine means what? They are only present in oceans. Salt water. Okay, annelids commonly called bristle worms. Some are free moving and others burrowing are cubicolous. Some are free moving means some are, this is the nereis. We observe these. Okay. It is a free moving organism, but some of the polychaetes are live in the burrowing nature, means they dig the burrows and cubicolous also. Means filter feeders. Okay. They are use the filter feeding mechanism. That is a very long question, which is used for our future classes. Head is distinct with the sense organs. Here, head is present and with the so many sense organs such as eyes, tentacles, the touch very useful for the sense and pulse also. Okay, head is distinct with the so many sense organs. What are that? Eyes, tentacles, and pulse. Theropodia, which bear many setae. Here we already discussed in the 2 marks question. Here, theropodia present in the lateral appendages. What is that? And it have a many setae. It bears many setae. Okay, help in the locomotion and respiration also. It is a very important one, students. All of you remember this. The respiratory organ of the nereis means the polychaetes means here cete used for the locomotion as well as the respiration. Very important one. Okay, clitella means absent. The major organ present in annelids that is nothing but the clitellum. We already discussed in the case of earthworm type study. What is that? Clitellum. It is used for the storage of what is that? Worms. Next, clitellum is absent. They are the dioecious. And here, gonoducts are absent. Gonoducts also absent. And then, gametes are shed into coelom and passed out through the nephridio spores. Okay, gametes are shed into the coelom. Means here the gonads are absent. That's why here coelom stores the gametes. Generally, gonads stores the gametes. But in the case of the polychaete, the gonads are absent. So gametes are shed into the coelom and passed out through the nephridiophores. Through the nephridiophores, it passed out through. Okay, next, fertilization is external, means fertilization is occur in the outer side of the body. Outer side of the body. Okay, students. Then next, development includes trochophore larva. Which larva we will observe? Trochophore larva. These larval stages also important based on the this fertilization, means direct or indirect development. We will divide the organisms into direct development and indirect development. Development lo ante means here. Okay. Development include trochophore larva, means here larval stage is present in their life history. The type of development is called indirect development. But in the direct development, we does not observe any larval stages. Okay. Here the example is the nereis. What is the students? Nereis. Then next, this is also 1-4 marks question, very important. And here some important portions also. Next, what are the chief characters of crustaceans? Okay, it is also important, students. What is that? Crustacea. Okay, crustaceans also aquatic organisms. Aquatic means what? They are living in the water. And head and thorax fuse form the cephalothorax. Here, head and thorax fuse to form and forms the cephalothorax region here. In the case of prawns, we observe it will be mixed into head and neck region. Means it is a cephalothorax region. Here, exoskeleton hardened by calcium carbonate. Exoskeleton and endoskeleton also two types, students. What are their exoskeletons are used for the protection of the body? Here, exoskeleton is prepared by the which compound? Calcium carbonate. What is that? Calcium carbonate. And then next, cephalic region. In the cephalic region, this is all about the thorax and head region, cephalothorax, and another one is called cephalic region. Here we observe the two types of the antennae and one pair of the mandibles here. Next, two pairs of the maxillae. This count is very important. How many antennae is present? Two pairs. One pair of mandibles, two pairs of maxillae. Okay, this is about the crustacean, mandibles, maxillae, and antennae. Next, thoracic and abdominal appendages is biromas. Means, biromas means double. Appendages are in the double manner. Means, for example, it is a one appendage. Here, we observe the double. Okay. Next, respiratory organs are gills. What are the respiratory organs? Gills, because they are the aquatic, in the aquatic mode of the life, which type of the organs, respiratory organs are they use? Gills. The next, excretory organs are green glands and antennary glands. What are the excretory organs of crustacea? What is that, students? Green glands and antennary glands. The next, sense organs or antennae, camptodes, we observe in the portion of the cephalic region. Means cephalothorax region. Here we observe the compound eyes and two pairs of the antennae and statocyst also sense organ. And development is indirect, includes different larval forms. Development includes the indirect and so many larval forms we observe. Examples are the pelamon and cams. What is that, students? Pelamon and cancer are the examples for the class crustacea. Okay. The next, another important one. Compare briefly a centipede and a millipede. Centipedes and a millipede. Here, students, centipedes and millipedes means they are generally, they share the common characters. One or two differences we observe. What are that? Centipedes means 100 leggers. What is that? 100 leggers. 100 leggers. Okay. And they are the terrestrial. But in the case of millipedes, Diplopoda includes millipedes. Okay. What is that? Millipedes means 1000 leggers. How many legs we observe? 1000. In the case of the centipedes, how many legs we observe? 100. Here 1000 and here 100. Next two, they are the terrestrial. What is that? Terrestrial life means what? They live in the, only on the earth. Next two, these also terrestrial ones. Millipedes also terrestrial. And here, centipedes are the air-breathing animals. What is that? Air-breathing animals. Here, millipedes are also air-breathing animals because the mode of the life is terrestrial. So, that's why they are air-breathing animals. Both are the air breathers. Next to carnivorous animals. What is that, students? Carnivorous. But here, millipedes are the feeding on decaying plant material. Carnivores means what? They are eat both herbivores and okay, students, sorry, they are the herbivores, but here in the carnivores are the, they are eat the some small insects like that. They are the carnivores. But in the case of the millipedes, they eat feeding on decaying plant material, dead and decaying matter. Okay, students, each segment of the trunk bears a pair of cloud appendages. Here, students, all of you look into this picture. Here we observe the cloud appendages. What is that? Claw appendages. Okay, here. But here, body is divided into head and trunk region. Trunk region and head region we observe. Next, one pair of trunk appendages bear poison claws. One pair of trunk appendages bears poison claws. Here, trunk appendages bears a poisonous claws, which releases the poison. But in the case of the millipedes, the paired antennae, mandibles, and maxillae are present. Okay, paired antennae means two antennae is present and mandibles are present and maxillary is present, like this manner. Okay, in the case of these centipedes, we observe the respiratory structures, the trachea. Here also respiratory organs are trachea. In the case of the centipedes, excretory organs are Malpighian tubules. Here excretory organs are Malpighian tubules. Both are similar. Here examples are Scolopendra and here examples are Zoolas, Spirostreptus. Okay, they are the examples. These are the major differences and major similarities between them. Where the differences we observe means they are the carnivores, but here they are the feeding on the dead and decaying plant material. Okay, here the paired poison class is presented, but here we observe the antennae, mandibles, and maxillae are present. Okay, here respiratory organs are similar, excretory organs also similar. Okay, students, they are the major comparisons and differences between the centipedes and millipedes. Examples, Scolopendra. And here, Zoolas. What is that? Zoolas and Scolopendra. Okay, students, and another question. What are the silent features of the echinoids? What are the silent features of echinoids? Here. All of you observe. Echinoidea includes echinoderms. Echinoidea means what, students? Echinoderms. Popularly called sea urchins. What is that? Popularly called sea urchins. Okay. These echinoidean organisms are popularly known as the sea urchins, hot urchins, cake urchins, and sand dollars. They are the their general names. What are the, students? Hot urchins, sea urchins, cake urchins, and sand dollars. So many food items is there. There are 950 species of known echinoids. How many species we observe? 950 species of the echinoids we observe. Okay, the silent features of echinoidea are the following. Body is globular, oval, discoidal or heart shaped with definite oral and aboral surfaces. Okay, students, your body is in the globular manner and oral and discoidal or heart shaped, like the different shapes we observe in the echinoids. Okay, arms and umbilical grooves are absent. Here umbilical grooves where, because they are the echinoderms, means here the specialized system is present. Where the specialized system is present in the echinoids, what is that? Water vascular system. We already discussed about this. Okay, the water in the water vascular system we observe the tube feet, okay, sieve plate, next to umbilical grooves, like that. Here arms and umbilical grooves are absent in the case of echinoidea. The whole body is enclosed in a box like shell. Okay, the whole body is enclosed in a box like shell known as corona or test. Okay, what is the box like structure name? The test. It is formed of calcareous plates. Calcareous plates. It is this test means the box like structure is formed with the calcareous plates. Okay, one or the test and covering the whole body. The test is covers the whole body of echinoidea is an immature or immovable spines. Okay, it have a mature or movable spines are present. Here echinoidea means what? Means echinodermata means what, student? The spiny skin. The spiny skin is present in the organism. So here the movable spines are present in the above structure of the organism. Okay, and mouth is surrounded by leathery membrane called peristome and anus by periprop. Okay, here mouth is surrounded by leathery membrane called peristome. Here for example, it is echinoid. Here the mouth is covered by a one layer that called a, what is that? Peristome. The anus means the lower position, the periprop. What is that? Periprop. Mouth is armed with characteristic chewing apparatus called Aristotle lantern. We already discussed in the 2 marks question. What will we observe? Aristotle lantern. Here physeoid structure is present. What is that, students? Physeoid structure. This is the Aristotle lantern at the mouth region. Arranged in between the spines and extending between the peristome and periproctor, 5 double rows of the tube feet. Here, between the spines, here in the oral surface or body surface, we observe the spine and peristome and periproct are 5 double rows of the tube feet. Here, tube feet also present, but umbilical grooves are absent at the oral region. Okay, then next. Sexes are separate. Sexes are separate means what? The male organism and female organism are separate. Development is indirect. Development is indirect with characteristic larva called echinopluteus. This is also one important bit, students. What is the larval form of the echinoidea? Echinopluteus. Okay, your development is indirect. So development indirect, that's why the larval form is present. Which larval form? Echinopluteus. Okay, what are the example here? Echinus is the important, echinocardium, echinodiscus and clypeosphere. Okay, they are the general characters of the echinoidea. Okay, and students, next to another question, what is that? What are the general characters or silent features of the holothuria? Another class which is present in echinodermata and important one. So many important bits is present in this. Okay, holothuria here. Yes, students, holothuria is a group of leathery or almost cylindrical echinoderms. Almost the body is like a in the cylindrical manner, commonly called sea cucumber. Cylindrical means what? It's look like a one Cucumber. The major diagnostic features of the holothrides are the following. Here, the important characters of the holothridea we observe. Body is a long, body is in the long form and like a cylindrical and almost bilaterally symmetrical. Bilaterally symmetrical. What is bilaterally symmetry? Means your body is divided into two equal parts. Body wall is little and dermomuscular. Here body wall is totally occupied by the dermomuscular. Means the muscle action is present. Okay, the next, mouth and anus are opposite end. Mouth is present in the one side and anus is present in the another side. Okay, mouth is encircled by crown of retractile tube feet. Here students, all of you look into this picture. Here, this is the mouth of the holothridea. Here, the crown, mouth is, for example, it is a mouth of the holothridea. Here, crown-like structure is present and tube feet and buccal podia, which are modified as oral tentacles. Here, it is look like a one crown of retractile and tube feet also present, known as buccal podia. This is known as buccal podia, which is modified as a oral tentacles. They all are look like a oral tentacles. Okay, which are used for the sensory, And then students, radial arms, spines and pedicellae are present here also. Radial arms means what? Look like this. They are the radial arms and spines. Spines also present and pedicellae also present in the body. The next, dermal ossicles are microscopic. Dermal ossicles are microscopic means what? They are the small structures and vestigial. Their function is not mentioned. And loosely scattered. Loosely scattered means they are did not attached in a tight manner. They attached into a loose manner. That's why they are the loosely scattered. Okay. Next, umbilical grooves are absent and madreporate is internal. In most cases, madreporate canals have no external opening or hydropore. Here, students, umbilical grooves means here, for example, it is a one arm of the echinodermata. It is a radial canal, we already know. Here, tube feet we observe. And also, we observe in this position, what is that, student? Umbilical grooves. Okay, these umbilical grooves are absent. What is that? Absent. And madreporate is present in the internal. So many organisms of the echinoderms have the madreporate in the external manner. But in the holothrides are madreporate in the internal. In most cases, madreporic canals have no external openings or hydropore. Here, madreporate have a one opening which are used for the filtering of the water. Okay. But in the what will happen in most cases, madreporate canals have no external openings. In the case of the holothridea, what will happen? The madreporate openings we did not observe. No external openings and no external hydropores. Okay, the next, alimentary canal is long and coiled with a definite cloaca. Here, alimentary canal is a long. Alimentary canal means what, students? The digestive system is a long one. Okay, and coiled means what? It is look like a coil manner with a definite cloaca. It have a definite cloaca. Next, connected to the cloaca are the so-called respiratory trees of cloaca gills. Here, the cloaca is also connected by some respiratory trees. They are used for the exchange of gases which are present in the near the gills. Okay, next, circulatory system is more advanced than that of other echinoderms. Here, circulatory system by other echinoderms does not develop any circulatory system. Means here, specialized system we observe. What is that? Water vascular system. So, that's why the circulatory system of the organisms are collapsed. But in the case of holothridea, again, is that echinoderms, what will we observe? Circulatory system is more advanced than that of other echinoderms. And it functions to transport oxygen and perhaps nutritive also. Okay, and here they are used for the transportation of oxygen and perhaps nutrients also. Okay, next, the development includes with characteristic larva called auricularia. What is the larva of Holothuria, students? Auricularia. Okay. The next example, Holothuria, Mesothuria, Cucumeria, Thion, Synapta, okay, like that, so on. So many examples is there. Okay, students, here also we observe the so many important things. What are there, students? Here again is the echinoderms. We observe the circulatory, developed circulatory system, and then umbilical grooves absent, madrephorate is internal, and here respiratory trees are the used for the respiration through the gills. They are the important one. They are the general characters of Holothuria. Okay, students. Then next, we enter into the digestive system of earthworm. It is the 8 marks question, which is okay, long answer question. What is that? Digestive system and process of digestion in Peritima. Here, Peritima means what, students? The earthworm. What is that? Earthworm. Earthworm. Okay, it is the picture of the earthworm. Okay, what we observe? The digestive system. Okay. Here the alimentary canal is a straight tube. It runs from the first to the last segment. Okay, students, what will happen here? The alimentary canal is a straight tube. It runs from the first to last segments of the body. First to last segments of the body. Here we observe the, this is the one earthworm body. We observe the, this is the anterior portion. And here we observe the different segments like 1, 2, so on, 120 or 130. Okay. Here we observe the elementary canal is a straight tube and runs from first segment to last segment. First segment to last segment, we observe the long tube, that is the elementary canal. Next, the mouth. The mouth region is opens into buccal cavity. Here, mouth region is open into the buccal cavity. Here, where the mouth is present? In the first segment. Okay, in which segment, students? In the first segment, we observe the mouth. This mouth is open into the buccal cavity. Which portion? Buccal cavity. Next, next one. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Buccal cavity. Next, into the, this buccal cavity is enter into the muscular pharynx. In the fourth segment, we observe the muscular pharynx. Okay, then next, a small narrow tube, esophagus. A small narrow tube, esophagus is present from where? From fifth to seventh segments. Fifth to seventh segments. Okay, continues into a muscular gizzard. It continues into the muscular gizzard. Where the gizzard is present? Here in the eighth segment, we observe the muscular gizzard. Okay, students, here from the mouth. Mouth is start from the first segment and then mouth is open into the buccal cavity. Which one? 1, 2, 3. Next, this buccal cavity is enter into the pharynx region. Okay, fourth one. Next, this pharynx is leads into the esophagus. 5 to 7. Here we observe fifth to seventh segment. Continues into a muscular gizzard. Muscular means what, students? It have a muscle nature and used for a rupturing of the food, grinding mill of the food of the earthworm. Okay, next, it helps in grinding the small particles of a food, the decaying leaves. That's why it's called as a grinding mill. It helps in grinding. This gizzard is helps in the grinding the small particles of the food. Which type of the food earthworm will take? Means the decaying leaves, the soil, like that. Okay, it does not any eat a chicken, mutton, like that. So the primitive organism have a primitive system. Okay, here the small particles of the food is used for the decaying leaves, and so it leads into the grinding mill. The stomach extend from the segments 9 to 14. Here students, 9 to 14, we observe the stomach region. Okay, the food of earthworm is decaying leaves and other organic matter mixed with the soil. Here, what is the food of earthworm? We already discussed about this. What is the food? Okay, the earthworm food is decaying leaves and other organic matter mixed with the soil. Okay, here stomach, whatever type of stomach, here stomach is neutralized the humic acid present in the humus of the soil, student. Here, this is also important. Here, stomach, it neutralizes the humic acid because it eats the dead and decaying leaves and the soil. In the soil, the humic acid is in the rich portion. So this humic acid is, whenever it increases, it collapses the digestive system of the earthworm. So here, stomach is neutralized the humic acid present in the humus of the soil. Okay, that's why the stomach region also very important, because it performs the neutralizing function. Okay, here it neutralizes the humic acid present in the humus of the soil. Okay, next one. Okay students, then next, after that, the calciferous glands are present at the stomach region and neutralize the humic acid present in the humus of the soil. And then next to intestine, what about of intestine? In the 15th segment to last segment, where the intestine is present, from the 15th segment to the last segment, 15 to last segment, we observe the intestine of the earthworm. Okay, here we observe the one pair of conical intestinal cheekae. Here it is very important, student. Here one pair of the conical, what is that? Intestinal cheekae. Like this manner. What is the function of these? 26th segment, we observe the one pair of conical intestinal segment cheekae. What is the function? Okay, it performs the folding. And internal median fold is present in the intestine, that is called typhlosole. What are the typhlosole, students? Here, the folding of the inner folding of the intestine and forms the median fold, that nothing but the typhlosole. Okay, it helping the increasing the area of absorption. It is very important, students. What is that? Increasing the area of the absorption. Why? Because it does not have any developed system. It does not have a different absorption. So that's why in the primitive organisms, the primitive organs performs the total function. Mouth to anus. In the human alimentary canal also, we observe the mouth to anus. Means mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx. But in the case of primitive organisms, what will we observe? We observe the only primitive functions. Here, these intestinal foldings are used for the helping the increasing of the surface area, which is used for the observing, which is used for the absorption. Okay, then next to last one, alimentary canal opens into the anus. In which region, students? Alimentary canal opens into anal region. Okay, all of you understand? The digestive system of earthworm, this is also important. From mouth to anus, we observe mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, and segment numbers also very important. In the first segment, we observe the mouth, and the second one, second to third, buccal cavity, and the next to fourth one, pharynx, and fifth to seventh, what will you observe? Esophagus. In the eighth segment, we observe the muscular gizzard, And next, from this, after the gizzard, we observe the stomach from ninth segment. And after that, in the stomach, we observe the nutrient, the neutralized material, which is used for the, this one students, the neutralized the humic acid, which is present in the humic of the soil. And then next, from the 15th segment, after starting from the 15th segment and ending on the last segment, we observe the so long intestine. What is that? Intestine. In the intestine, we observe the, which one? The foldings. What are the foldings? Typhlosole. The typhlosole is used for the increasing the absorption area and helping the for the absorption of the food for the earthworm. And the last one is the alimentary canal opens out into the anus. What is that, student? Anal region. This is also 8 marks question in this year. Okay. Digestive system, very important. And then student, and next question, draw the neat label diagram of the reproductive organs of the peritivum. Here this is also 8 marks question, very important. Means here in this year, because it is not a 8 marks weightage chapter in the previous IP exams, but in the COVID conditions, the third chapter also given for the weightage of 8 marks. That's why we are studying this 8 marks question. Draw the neat label diagram of the reproductive organs of peritivum. Okay, students, here. All of you observe from first segment to last segment. From first to last segment, we will observe by the segmented manner, means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this. Okay, here, first segment, and here spermatheca is present. All of you look into the first point. Yes, spermatheca is very important. Okay, what is the function of spermatheca, students? What is the function of spermatheca? All of you recall that. Okay. What is the function of spermatheca? It stores the spermatozoa, which is used for a male sperm. Okay. It stores the spermatozoa. In which segment it present? Spermatheca are located in the segments of 6th to 9th segment. Okay, they receive, store the spermatozoa during the copulation. During the which situation, students? Copulation. Okay. Next one. Testis. Next point. What about of testis? Okay. All of you look into this picture. Here, testis is present. There are two pairs of the testis is present. And one pair of present in the 10th and 11th segment. One pair is present in the 10th and 11th segment. Okay, next. What is the function of the testis? It is a chief male reproductive organ and maintains the hormonal balance. Okay, and then next to here, two pairs of the testes are present. And then next to testis sac. Here, testes are present in the sac-like structure. That is nothing but the testis sac. Okay. Then next. Here, spermidical funnels. Here we observe the spermidical funnels. Means, here, students, we observe the funnel-like structures, spermidical funnels. They are support the spermatogonia, which is when the sperms are released from the earthworm during the copulation. They support the testes and spermatheca. Next, seminal vesicles are present here. The seminal vesicles here. Okay, and they are also vesicles which present in the 11th and 12th segment, sacs in which spermatogonia mature into the spermatozoa. Here we observe the two pairs of the seminal vesicle present in the 11th and 12th segment, students. Here the segments are used for the means this sacs are used for the which spermatogonia mature into the spermatozoa. Means in the immature forms we observe the spermatogonia. This spermatogonia is converted into matured spermatozoa. Okay. The next, these are the male reproductive organs. Okay. These are the most important male reproductive organs. First of all, this earthworm is a hermaphrodite. Okay. We already know about this. Hermaphrodite means what, students? Yeah. The male reproductive organs and female reproductive organs present in the single organism. They are the hermaphrodite. So here, they produce the male reproductive organs and female reproductive organs. Okay. Here we observe the male reproductive organs like this. What are that? Tell me one second. Spermatheca, testes, testis sac, spermatical funnel, seminal vesicles. What are that? Seminal vesicles. They are the male reproductive organs. Here, from first onwards, we discuss about this. There are two pairs of the testes we observe, and one pair of each present in the 10th and 11th segment, one pair in the 10th segment, and another pair in the 11th segment. And their vasa differentia run up to 18th segment. Okay, this vasa differentia may runs into the 18th segment, where they join the prostatic ducts also. They reach the prostatic ducts. And two pairs of seminal vesicles we observe. How many pairs, students? Two pairs of the seminal vesicle present in the 11th and 12th segment. 11th segment and 12th segment. A sacs in which spermatogonia mature into the spermatozoa. This spermatogonia is used for the mature into the spermatozoa. Next, the common prostatic and spermatic ducts open into the here. Look into this picture. Common prostatic and spermatic ducts are open into the exterior by the pair of male genital pores. Here, male genital pores are present, student. From this pore, the common prostatic and spermatic ducts are open into the outside. Okay. Next, the ventrolateral side means what? Ventral region, this is the dorsal, and remaining portion means the ventral region in the this is the lateral region, ventrolateral region. Here in the ventrolateral region, the genital pores are opens in the 18th segment. Which segment? 18th segment. Two pairs of accessory glands also present. How many pairs? Two pairs of the accessory glands are present. Are one pair each in the 17th segment and the 19th segment. In the 17th and the 19th segment, we observe the accessory glands. Okay. And four pairs of spermatheca. How many pairs? Spermatheca are in here. Four pairs. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Four pairs of the spermatheca we observe in the segments of which segments? 6th to 9th. 6th to 9th. One pair and a each segment means in the sixth segment one pair, in the seventh segment one pair, like this manner. Okay. During the one pair in the each segment, they receive and store spermatozoa. What is the function of this? They receive and store the spermatozoa during which one? The copulation. What is that, student? The copulation reason. Okay, then next to these all are going to the male reproductive organs. Okay. Male reproductive organs. In the female portion, we observe the okay, students, here. They both are the female reproductive organs. What are there? One pair of ovaries and one oviducts. One pair of ovaries and ovidexter we observe. Here in the ovary, what will happen? One pair of ovaries attached to the posterior face of the intersegmental septum of the 12th. Here in the 12th region, 12th segment region, we observe the one pair of ovaries attached to the posterior face of the intersegmental septum of the 12th and 13th segments. Inter means the middle portion of the 12th and 13th segment. Oviducal funnels are present beneath the ovaries. Here oviducal funnels also we will observe like this we observe. Okay, oviducal final funnels are present beneath the ovaries and they continue into oviducts. They continue into oviducts in the 14th segment. They join together and open to the exterior on the ventral side of the 14th segment. Okay, student. They join together and open into the exterior to the ventral side of the 14th segment by a single median female genital pore. Okay. This is all about the reproductive system of earthworm. Okay, student. I hope that you all understand in today's class and remaining portion we will discuss in the tomorrow class. Thank you very much, students. Hello? Hello? Hello?